Hey everyone, welcome back to the current affairs series of agriculture and rural development. My name is Pooja Rawat and this is our 23rd session in this series. Before we start our session, all those people who are here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that you don't miss on the latest updates. You can also join our Telegram group wherein you can post your queries and you'll also be notified with the upcoming sessions and the latest exam notification. Let's start our session, and this is the first question. It says, how much financial assistance will be provided by the center to these FPOs under the PM Kisan FPO scheme? Okay, let us first understand what is FPO. FPO stands for Farmers Producer Organization. Alright, so Farmer Producer Organizations, these are the voluntary organization which require at least 11 members to form this organization. Now this organization need to maintain a network of 100 to 300 farmers based on the region they are operating in, right? Now what is the significance of FPO? What is the importance of FPO? Why the government is pushing a lot of efforts on creating more and more FPOs in the near future? So benefit FPO ka ye hai ki इंडियन एग्रीकल्चर सिनेरियो को आप देखें, इंडियन एग्रीकल्चर इस टाइम पे प्रेजेंटली द लैंड होल्डिंग साइज इज डिक्रीजिंग, राइट? द लैंड होल्डिंग साइज इज डिक्रीजिंग एंड मोर देन 80% ऑफ द फार्मर्स विच एंगेज्ड इन एग्रीकल्चर एक्टिविटीज दीज आर स्मॉल एंड मार्जिनल फार्मर्स. ओके, दे डू नॉट हैव इकोनॉमीज ऑफ स्केल, दे कैन नॉट इम्प्लीमेंट द लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजीज विच आर अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट ओइंग टू द स्मॉल फार्म साइज, right? And they do not have the good bargaining capacity for their produce because they're not producing these product on a very large scale, right? These are very small farmers. They have land of less than 2 hectares, right? So they do not have these bargaining capacity, and that's why they are frequently involved in the distress sale of their produce, right? Now what FPO can do is it can engage all these small and marginal farmers and can encourage them for the collective farming, right? And can also address the issue of productivity, the low productivity that is arising from these small farm size, right? So this is the reason behind the government pushing a lot of efforts on creating more and more FPOs, right? So now we have understood about the FPO, and this scheme PM Kisan FPO scheme is actually providing or giving a financial assistance to these FPOs so that they can maintain their activities, right? So correct answer here is 15 lakh. So this 15 lakh would be given to these FPOs in a period of 3 years, alright? Now let us understand what is Kisan FPO scheme is. First, it is a central sector scheme. That means all the financial burden, all the financial outlay would be from the central government only. Now, under this scheme, a financial assistance of 15 lakh will be provided by the center to these FPOs within the 3 years. Okay, so this 15 lakh will be given to these FPOs within a period of 3 years for this agriculture purpose. Now farmers will have to form their own organization. To take the advantage of this scheme, these farmers need to organize themselves into a cooperative, into a FPO, a farmer producer organization. For that, they need at least 11 members to come forward to form this organization. And now based on the region they are working in, they have to maintain a network of farmers. For example, if they're working in a plain region, then they have to maintain a network of 300 farmers, right? So 300 farmers need to be connected with them. And if they're working in a hilly area, then at least 100 farmers need to be connected with them, right? So based on the region they are working in, a network of said farmers have to be maintained. Now with this scheme, and now they're getting this financial assistance, so it will be easy for the farmers who are associated with the organization to purchase essential items like seeds, fertilizers and the agriculture equipments, right? So now they can easily buy the quality or certified seeds or fertilizers, and all the machineries that are needed in the farm mechanization, right? So they can go for farm mechanization now because there's a network of 300 farmers, right? 100 to 300 farmers, which is a huge number. By the year 2024, the government has a target to spend 6,865 crore rupees on PM Kisan FPO Yojana, right? So this is the target of the government and they're going to spend this much amount on this scheme. So I hope it's understand what is FPO and how does this scheme works and what is the benefit of FPOs. Moving forward to the next question, it says recently launched Atmanirbhar Krishi app will provide farmers what? So this Krishi app is has been launched under Krishi Mitra initiative. All right, this Krishi Mitra initiative was undertaken by principal scientific advisor. So Krishi Mitra initiative ke under kya hota hai ki there are different services being provided to the farmers through this portal. So Krishi Mitra portal tha jahan pe aap livestock sector ke bare mein, then agriculture technology ke bare mein, international collaborations ke bare mein information ko gather kar sakte hain. Now under this initiative, this Atmanirbhar Krishi app has been launched to assist the farmers in making a decision with respect to the cropping pattern or the kind of implement or the technology they can use on their farm, right? So all these decisions will be based on the data they are deriving from this Atmanirbhar Krishi app. Now what is the purpose of this? The correct answer here would be A, that is the agriculture insights and weather alerts. So this app will give information related to the agriculture insights, that means everything related to soil, your weather and the crops that you can grow. Okay, all these information would be provided through this app. Now let us study this in detail. So Union Government has launched this app in order to provide farmers the actionable agriculture insights, like what are the actions they can take, like, and the weather alerts. All right, so what kind of monsoon is going to be there and what kind of crop they can grow based on these data. Now data related to soil health, soil type, weather, moisture and water table. So data related to these factors are aggregated and these data have been analyzed and now it generates a personalized insights to the related to the fertilizer requirement, crop selection, water needs for each farmer at the farm holding level. Now is app ke through hoga kya agar farmer ne is app ko download kar liya hai, they can feed in their pin code. Theek hai, pin code dalna hoga. Us pin code ke zariye there will be a personalized data or information that would be provided to that farmers. Okay, so region specific data will be provided to the farmers and this will help farmer in making better choices related to the fertilizer or the crop selection and the water that the farmer going to need. Now this app is available in 12 languages. Okay, so at present this app is available in 12 languages. The data will be utilized by farmers, Krishi Vigyan Kendras, NGOs, self-help groups or the startups. So this is absolutely free for all these organizations. So apart from individual farmers, these different NGOs and self-help groups or startups, agri startups can also utilize this data, right, for better policy framing or better technology development, right? The information on the app when used by the farmers to make decision on the cropping pattern or the stubble burning or the mechanization of small farmers holding will ensure that these decisions are being taken factoring in the importance of sustainability of water, environment and judicious use of information. For example, agar koi bhi farmer hai wo dryland area region mein, dryland region mein rehta hai, and if that farmer is utilizing this app, then Obviously, he is going to get information regarding the water table, the water condition, or the soil moisture that is present. So, uska jo crop selection hoga, that would be in line with these conditions also, in these conditions. Right? So, jo crop selection hoga, wo is type ka crop selection hoga, that is suitable for the region. Right? So, एग्रोक्लाइमेटिक कंडीशंस को देखते हुए क्रॉप का सिलेक्शन होगा राइट तो ऐसा नहीं है ड्राईलैंड एरिया में कोई फार्मर है और उसको ये सारी इंफॉर्मेशन उसके पास अवेलेबल है एंड स्टिल ही इज गोइंग फॉर द वाटर गजलिंग क्रॉप्स लाइक राइस और शुगर केन है ना ही डेफिनेटली गो फॉर ज्वार बाजरा और मिलेट्स इस टाइप की क्रॉप्स को वो कल्टिवेट करेगा सो बेस्ड ऑन दीज डेटा द फार्मर्स विल फैक्टर इन द water sustainability or the environment condition of the region, right? So this is the importance of this Atmanirbhar Krishi app. This information will make the farmer self-reliant in taking the decisions for himself. Now the third question here is, certifying agency for Egmark is, Egmark kya hota hai? Pehle to ye pata hona chahiye. Egmark two words se milkar bana hai. First is AG, that stands for agriculture products, alright? And the second is MARC. MARC is basically your certifying mark. That means ki agriculture product ko certify kiya ja raha hai, right? जो सर्टिफाई करने का पर्पस क्या होता है सो दैट उसकी जो क्वालिटी है वो इस्टैब्लिश की जाए स्टैंडर्ड जो है उसकी जो ग्रेडिंग है वो इस्टैब्लिश किए जाए सो दैट फार्मर्स कैन गेट गुड प्राइस फॉर देयर प्रोड्यूस राइट और कंज्यूमर के लिए भी इट्स गुड बिकॉज इट इंश्योर्स कंज्यूमर ऑफ द बेटर क्वालिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट राइट सो अगर मैं कंज्यूमर हूँ और आई नो इट इज़ Egmark सर्टिफाइड दैट मीन्स इट अ गुड क्वालिटी प्रोडक्ट देन आई कैन ईजिली give a good amount, a good price for that product, right? अगर मुझे quality ensure करा दी जाए तो I'll be more than happy to give a good price for that product, right? So certifying agency for Egmark is option you have is SSAI, Director of Marketing and Inspection, Bureau of Indian Standards or NAFIN. So correct option here is a Director of Marketing and Inspection. This is an attached office to Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, right? So this agency is responsible for certifying these agricultural products. Now the next question we have, consider the following statement with respect to palm oil import. So palm oil hamesha news mein rehta hai because iska jo import hai wo it's increasing day by day and India has a dedicated mission on this palm oil, right? So what Indian government is trying that India should be self-reliant in producing this palm oil. And currently we are importing it from the Southeast Asian countries, especially the Indonesia and Malaysia. Okay. So most of the or majority of the palm oil import is from these countries. First statement here is India is the world's biggest importer of palm oil. Absolutely correct. India is the world's biggest importer of palm oil. After that, China stands second, and the Asian countries are responsible for around 60% of the palm oil consumption. Right, so India is the world's biggest importer of palm oil. Second statement here is India has cut import tax on crude palm oil from 15% to 10% for 3 months. Yes, so this was in news recently, and the government has cut this import tax from 15% to 10%. So this will reduce the price of palm oil, right? Or in the last 2 years, this palm oil price has almost doubled, right? So it's putting a pressure on consumer. So government has come up with this policy or this initiative on cutting down this import tax from 15% to 10%. All right, so both these statements are correct, and the correct option here would be C, that is both. Now, the last question of today's series is, Glen, Keat and Sonaro are the varieties of what? So, option here are mango, banana, pineapple and turmeric. The correct option here is A, that is mango. So, these are the varieties of mangoes. These are the recently developed varieties. And it has been developed by a Pakistani national in the Sindh region. Right? So, purpose kya hai iska aur significance kya hai? So, these varieties are low in sugar content. ठीक है, लो इन शुगर कॉन्टेंट. सो नियरली 4-6% शुगर कॉन्टेंट है. इम्पॉर्टेंस है, दीज मैंगोज कैन बी ईटन बाय द डायबिटिक पेशेंट्स. राइट, देन इट दीज मैंगोज हैव इंक्रीज्ड शेल्फ लाइफ. ठीक है, शेल्फ लाइफ इनकी ज़्यादा है, डायबिटिक पेशेंट्स कैन यूटिलाइज कर सकते हैं. एंड द ग्रोअर्स ऑफ दीज वराइटीज ऑफ मैंगोज कैन गेट गुड प्राइस फॉर दिस प्रोडक्ट. ठीक, तो इसकी अगर आप देखें तो एक्सपोर्ट पोटेंशियल इज क्वाइट गुड. बिकॉज देर आर लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु लव मैंगो. राइट, बट ये भी आपको पता होगा कि डायबिटीज इज इंक्रीजिंग डे बाई डे. राइट, अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम दिस डायबिटीज, टाइप 1 और टाइप 2. ऑलराइट, सो इन दैट सिनेरियो दीज वराइटीज ऑफ मैंगो हैव अ गुड पोटेंशियल इन द कमिंग फ्यूचर. द फार्मर्स कैन गेट गुड प्राइस. राइट, एंड द फार्मर्स ऑफ डिफरेंट कंट्रीज कैन ग्रो दीज वराइटीज ऑफ मैंगो. So this was all about it. Remember this, these types of questions are asked in NABARD about the varieties of different crops. So keep that in mind. So this is all about the today's session. I hope you like it. In case you have any queries, do post it down. All right. And we'll see you in the next session. Till then, keep working hard. Keep studying.